BBC Audio presents a full-cast dramatisation of Noughts and Crosses, a thrilling adaptation of Malorie Blackman's best-selling novel.
Noughts and Crosses by Malorie Blackman. Dramatised for radio by Janice Oko.
Funny, I can't remember when we first met.
I can't remember when Callum's mother began working for mine. I was far too small.
Mum used to tell me stories of how she'd take me to work with her.
Meggie, she was our housekeeper.
How I used to help change Sephy's nappy. As if.
Callum and I would play together every day until I was about 10. I was 10 when Meggie left us.
My mum stopped working for the Hadleys, I was 12. Had her feet too far under the table, was all she'd say.
But we didn't stop seeing each other.
My mum says a Noughts and Crosses can never be friends because they believe they're better than us.
We had a secret signal we'd use for emergencies. It was...
because they were never slaves.
He'd phone me 3 times or I would phone him. Each time we'd let the phone ring twice before calling off.
But I believed we were different.
Ring, ring. Like that.
We had a secret place away from all that.
I'd always catch it by the second set of rings, otherwise my parents would get suspicious.
Our secret place on the edge of their beach, when no Noughts or Crosses could ever find us.
Okay, so we were young when we came up with it, but it worked.
They had a beach. Even for a cross, that was saying something.
Sorry I'm late.
Flowers? Well, I didn't know you cared.
Oh, very funny. They're for your sister. I thought she might like them, help her, you know, feel.
They're nice.
It was just a thought.
Yeah, a good one, Sif. Thanks. You bring your books?
Yeah.
There's a butt in there.
Callum, it's too hot.
Oh, I'm not going to give them a reason to kick me out.
They won't. You're in now. They've accepted you.
Look, being in and being accepted are 2 different things. Besides, I need to learn as much as I can. I don't want to look like a complete div.
You won't.
No, Sif.
Okay. I just hope they put us in the same class.
Oh, I'm sure you'd like to be stuck with a bunch of 15-year-olds if you were nearly 17.
But the headmaster explained all of this.
Look, our schools are crap, Sephy. They don't get half as much money as yours. Why didn't you talk about that?
Well, now you're in, you can show everyone what you can do.
Oh, look, it speaks. Let's play with the pet monkey.
That's not what I meant. And you know it. Maths or history?
Maths. I want to go over polygons and maybe, if we have time...
What do you mean, if we have time?
I can't stay long. I've got things to do at home.
Oh, right.
Yeah, vulgar fractions. Show me again how they work.
Things to do at home. As if. Of course I wanted to stay. It was our place. Away from the rubbish, the junkies, the tramps, piss, the food queues, the curfews, the blackouts, the paper-thin walls.
Yeah, but I'm not sure how to play it. Smart or laid back.
Where have you been?
Dad, smart or laid back?
Well, I'll go smart, son. You can always take your time.
Callum!
You know where he was.
That way you got those?
I got these from the market. They're for Linny. This stallholder was gonna bin him. She upstairs?
She's resting. She had one of her turns today.
Oh, you never said, love.
Yeah, well.
They're getting worse.
Think I don't know.
What I'll do is I'll go casual. Take a tie if I need it, wear my hair in a ponytail.
You need to cut it, Jude. It gives the wrong impression.
Jude's got an interview, Cal. Garland's furniture shop.
Well, in the shopping centre.
It's money.
Sure is.
Well, let's get the job first. And you still haven't tidied your part of the room, Jude.
If I get this job, I'll move out anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, get you something nice, a dress maybe for going out, and Dad...
Oh, when do I go out?
Well, I'll take you out, love. I'll take you dancing.
Dancing? Can't remember the last time I went.
I do. We went to visit your Amanda's, remember? She was seeing that Nought doctor.
Oh, she had that one date.
Aunt Amanda saw a Nought doctor?
Yeah, they do exist, son.
What, like completely Nought?
Well, he was mixed race.
Knew it. If you're black, that's where he's at. If you're brown, stick around. If you're white...
Well, I wasn't really paying much attention to what he was, because me and your mother had just you do remember.
What? Just been what?
We had just...
Ryan!
What? Callum, what?
You don't want to know. So, how about it, Meg? Going dancing.
You guys, you well need to grow up.
School, I couldn't wait.
Oh. What are you doing up?
Can't sleep.
Don't bang it so hard.
I wanted to show him the playing fields, the swimming pool, the gym and the music rooms. Just all the things he hadn't had at his old school.
Persephone! Oh,
sorry, I forgot. How was your day today, Mother?
I wanted to introduce him to my friends who love him. See how funny and caring and how great he was.
I'll take this up to my room then.
Persephone?
Yes, Mother?
What did I tell you about not wearing slippers?
Yes, Mother.
The Liberation Militia are growing impatient with the rate of change in this country, sir.
I've already opened the door to Noughts in the army, the police force.
That was more to do with pressure from the Pan EC, sir.
I hadn't meant to listen.
I thought letting a few blankers into our schools would have shut them up. Who are they anyway?
Blankers. That was the first time I'd ever heard Dad refer to Noughts in that way.
So I'm not going to lose my position in the cabinet because of some terrorist rabble-rouser.
Blankers. I mean, who even thought up that word? It's so ugly, so hateful.
I was just coming to...
What are you doing there?
Pardon?
What did you hear, Princess?
Nothing. I came down for some milk. I couldn't sleep. I didn't see or hear anything, I promise.
But I had. I'd seen him. The man. Seen his reflection in the hall mirror.
Go to bed. It's late.
Good night, Dad.
Oh, Princess! Wait. I'm sorry I was a bit abrupt. It's been a long week.
You've got to step this way.
What for?
Do as he says.
Stay where you're going.
About my own business? To the shopping centre.
What for?
A job interview?
Oh, really? Palm to the scanner.
Why?
It's routine.
You're routinely checking crosses
just
too?
Just to place your palm to the scanner.
Jude McGregor, 19 years old, unemployed, no convictions. Registered at number 14, Meadowview.
Off you go, then. Go on, move on.
Yes, sir. Dagger scum.
What did he say?
Just forget it.
You boy, come here, yeah? Say what you said. Go on, say it.
Ruler?
Yep.
Calculator?
I've got it.
Sorry, it's not new.
Well, at least I've got one.
I am proud of you. You do know that.
Of course.
Just be careful around them. We can never be friends with them, Cal.
But you were friends with Mrs. Hadley once.
I wasn't.
No, I remember.
Yeah, well, that was a mistake.
You ready for school tomorrow, son?
Ready as I'll ever be.
The lads down the yard club together. It's not real leather, but it's as good as.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
Now, you make sure you're on your best behaviour in there. You've got to show them that they're wrong about us, that we're just as good as they are.
He doesn't need to go to their stuck-up school to show them that.
He does, if he's going to get anywhere in this life. He has to learn to play the game by their rules, be better at it than they are. And next it'll be university, Callum. Then, whatever you want to be. A lawyer, a fancy doctor, even, eh?
Prime Minister.
Yeah, more Prime Minister.
Not in our lifetime.
Just ignore us, son. If the interview didn't go well, don't show it.
Yeah.
Hey, son.
What's this?
We're getting ready for Cal's big day tomorrow.
Well?
Well, what?
You've been gone since morning.
Nice bag, little bro.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, Dad got it for me.
Jude? Is that... There's blood.
Where?
There, on your shirt.
Well, I must have fallen or something. Yeah, the interview went well, so I had a drink with some mates.
So it went well?
Yeah, there was loads of us there for the job, but, you know, they must have liked me. Yeah.
So that's what you've been doing all day? Drinking?
Give the boy a break, Meg. Son, I'm proud of you. Your first interview in years and you walked it. I am proud of both of you. Come here.
Oh, stop it.
Dad, get off. We're on our way up, finally, Meg. The McGregors are on their way up.
Up out of there, just like Dad said.
I couldn't stop thinking about him.
I was going to get a good job, buy a big house, make something of myself.
The blonde man in Dad's study.
Once I had a proper education behind me, I thought no one could say you're not smart enough.
I'd never seen a Nought in our house before, except in the kitchen or cleaning.
Say you're not good enough.
And the things they'd been saying. Yeah, I was still thinking about them on my way to school that day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.